Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On the SGI graph, we look at a magnitude 5.5 and larger earthquakes. And as I said in the previous update, we didn't have really critical planetary geometry, no planetary conjunctions, so I didn't expect really large seismic activity. And we see some minimal clustering as early as the 21st, but that was part of the clustering that occurred on the 20th and the 21st. And then we see a 5.5 and a 6.2, the largest seismic event actually on the 23rd. And the Kuril Islands, we had minimal clustering on the 25th with a 5.7 at Tonga and a 5.8 offshore Chiapas, Mexico. And also today, a magnitude 6 earthquake at New Britain region. I said around the 29th, it happened a little bit later on the 30th. So overall, no large seismic activity, no really critical geometry. And I discussed this all in detail in the previous update in case you missed it. So let's have a look at the next time frame up until November 8. We're going to have planetary conjunctions, critical geometry, because Earth will be between Venus and Jupiter. And as a result, we will also have critical lunar geometry. It happens first as we speak with Mercury-Earth-Uranus in a conjunction, and that will be followed by right-angle geometry Venus-Mercury-Jupiter. We're going to have quite some right-angle geometry involving Venus, pretty rare actually, in the coming days. And then we have Mercury-Venus and Saturn also in a conjunction, and that all happens just before the new moon on the 1st of November. In the solar system, we see this geometry actually, the two red lines, that's Mercury, Earth and Uranus in a conjunction, and then Mercury, Venus, Saturn in a conjunction. It's not a tight convergence of these planetary conjunctions. It is almost a near convergence. There are some 30 hours in between, but they both occur before the new moon. And we can see the moon there going counterclockwise, and it's almost new moon there. More importantly, we see the critical geometry involving the moon, Venus and Jupiter, 45 degrees with Venus and 135 degrees with Jupiter. And that happens on the 31st of October, later on the 31st and on the 1st of November. And there are only several hours in between. And as a result, we could see a higher 6, maybe even borderline 7 magnitude earthquake as a result within about 2 days. So that would be around the 3rd or 4th of November. Back to the SGI graph, we see the high lunar peaks as well. That is the moon in a conjunction with Uranus on the 2nd of November. And then we see a right angle geometry with Venus. That's Venus, Jupiter, Saturn on the 3rd. Also Venus, Earth, Saturn in a right angle. And that converges with the conjunction Venus, Earth, Jupiter. As a result, we could see an obvious seismic response. And I wouldn't be surprised if that would actually reach higher 6 to 7 magnitudes, again, around the 3rd or the 4th. And then we also have a high lunar peak on the 4th. And that's because of the moon in opposition with Jupiter and a conjunction with Venus. Again, because Earth is between Venus and Jupiter in the coming days. So that would possibly also mark the 6th of November as a candidate of largest seismic activity around the 6th, give or take 1 day. So I think that the largest seismic activity, clustering of strong earthquakes, high of 5, borderline 6 magnitude, is probably going to occur in the first half of this time frame with the planetary conjunctions, the new moon, and especially the right angle geometry with Venus around the 3rd, converging with Venus, Earth, Jupiter in a conjunction. We see that actually in the solar system here on the 3rd and the 4th, the critical geometry, Earth between Venus and Jupiter, and we see the moon going counterclockwise, moving to that purple line, a conjunction with Venus and an opposition with Jupiter. Check out the website for the latest updates, also the atmospheric fluctuations for potential regions. It wasn't really very active in the atmosphere in the last several days. We also didn't have large seismic activity in the previous time frame, actually. But check out the website and also the social media, Facebook, Telegram, WhatsApp. We have dedicated channels there for the atmospheric fluctuation updates. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.